everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. With that, the wait is finally over. It is Super Bowl Sunday. For the call, here's our veteran duo of so many Super Bowls, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we have played 266 games in this NFL season. Only one remains, and it's the biggest of them all, as EA Sports is proud to present coverage of the Super Bowl. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Offense still needing 10 yards, second down. They'll set up a throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a third and five. Now back to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
The punter Bosher on now as he gets this one away. This is taken at about the 14. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Niners will go on offense. First and 10. Tackle can't go very far. Stop short of the 30. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football getting away from one and trying to churn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll look to throw. And the Jets pressure too much as down he goes. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you get 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. He'll look to throw. Flush to his right. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A good pickup there, 26 yards. First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
No, 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 no.
A handoff as they run the counter play. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
The throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one.
He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line. Leonard Williams able to drop him for a loss of two, and that'll bring up fourth down. So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. This is away, and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And New York set to take the field. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. Three and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Now, let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands and make the offense move a little bit
better. Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Again, they run with Gurley, and this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one. Down here as he's taken down at the 24. He needed a yard, that's what he got, and it's going to earn him a new set of downs.
Here we go.
They're going to look to throw. Get there and bring him down. Solomon Thomas able to collapse the pocket and drop him for a loss of a yard.
Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Give him 12 yards there, and the Jets have a first.
Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Flushed out right. Finding some room at midfield. And he takes it all the way down to the 15. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down. So he wanted to pass it, but that thing turned out much better.
And the crowd really responded, didn't they? They always like it better when the quarterback is scrambling around, actually takes off and runs downfield. And that's exactly what he did.
Here's a carry now for Keith Marshall. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Now that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
They stay on the ground. This is Marshall again. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
That's how you get right up off of the mat, because on the last play, they stoned him in the backfield and dropped him for a loss. But he's the type of guy that scared me a little bit, because he's not daunted. Just got right back up, showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next run.
On first and goal, Gurley. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here this close. Sneak it?
I don't think you even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
They come out here in the eye. They'll try and push it in with Gurley. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. With the first touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Jets have taken a first quarter lead.
Brandon, this is the Super Bowl. A touchdown scored in any game is big. In this one, it's massive.
Sturgis out now to kick this one off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down.
And rush coming, and he's taken down.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Back to throw here. Throw left side complete. It's Collins. Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the 49ers in control of the football. And they've got it here with a first down. This time to the tailback. Looking for an opening. Not much there. He'll get it to the 39. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action and hit them over the top.
Now they're running on the toss. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That'll go as a loss of 5. And it'll be a 3rd and about 13. Looking to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And this one is incomplete.
But no second guessing the call here. It was 3rd and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. The Jets offense now works their way back onto the field. And they had to go the length of the field last time out to get into the end zone. And with this starting field position, they're going to have to pretty much do it again.
And I think the thought process going into it is, hey, if you have to be methodical, go ahead and do that. But what you really want are a couple of big plays. Eat up chunks of yardage and cut down the number of times you have to snap the football.
They'll try and start the drive with Gurley. And he'll lose yardage and be down at the 7-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL, and a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved and looked outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
There they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd. Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. They'll look to throw. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. And they're going to have this one up near the 30-yard line. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. At the 28. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you can see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There is nothing there for him.
They'll look to throw here. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. DeForest Buckner. Breaking through to get him for a loss of 7. Really in a hole here, 3rd and 17, following the 2 negative plays.
Come on, let's go.
They'll drop the throw. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Solomon Thomas in there to drop him, and back-to-back sacks now bring up 4th and long. There's Matt Bosher now, standing just about on his own goal line. He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And this is their 3rd drive. Maybe the focus right now, not so much on points, but getting their first down.
And when you start off a game, you don't even think that's an issue, do you? But you go a drive, a second drive, no first down, that becomes an issue. Now you got to think about, okay, what type of play calling do I have to do to get us in a spot to pick that first one up?
Broken tackle. And some room to roam now. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down.
Okay, he's not going to get the 1st down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
And he's going to be run over, hit hard, as he'll be marked down at the 29. Another big hitter there, this one good for 18. To throw now on 1st down. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Now the extra point try forthcoming.
Brandon, they just got the ball, and already they're in the end zone, and you're getting ready to talk about the PAT. That was fast.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. To throw. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. The Jets on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 11.
Let's go, Hunt. One, nine, Hunt.
He'll drop to throw. And the Niners get there and bring him down. Solomon Thomas in there to get him for his 2nd sack of the night.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And the punt will kick out of bounds, and it'll be spotted inside the 30-yard line. The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown, and now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Give him 4 yards on the play, and that will lead us into the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We'll come back on Super Bowl Sunday after this. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. All the way down inside the 35. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. And he'll give it here to his running back. And not much running room. Down to the 32. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. They'll set up to throw. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Back to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. A gain of 13 and also a 1st down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
In the red zone this time. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Looking left side. He's got it. Complete. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another 1st down.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover.
And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. A great play there, taking it in from 4 yards out. And the 49ers have now taken the lead. And he'll bang that one through. The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Jets offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
Escaping the pressure right. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Fresh set of downs here. Screen, it's complete. Well, first down screen pass, good for five.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Come on, let's go!
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Throw now on first down. Flush to his right. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Shotgun. He'll look to throw. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
Let's go! Ohio!
They'll throw now on the final play. He's going to air one out. And that is incomplete. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl, as we send you on down to our studios in Orlando, where standing by is Larry Ridley with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Second down following the run. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. The Niners on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. And now here's a carry heading left. And I don't think he got there. No, they stop him right where it all started. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on 4th. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And this will be taken at the 13. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Jets will take over 1st and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because
that's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two.
They'll stick to the ground game with Gurley. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a 3rd down and 4 now.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he's got the 1st down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs. First down, it's Gurley. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Dumps it off to Gurley. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be 3rd down.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way, and really we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
The Jets on 3rd down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This time it's 3rd and 3. One that's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It'll be a loss of 1, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 12. Sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete. Certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up 4th down.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
And he'll go ahead and field this at the 5. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Jets offense will be backed up to start this drive as they've got it 1st and 10. So out now come the Jets. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Gurley again here on first down. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Brought in by Coates. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. This is Marshall, and he is knocked down from the side at the 41-yard line. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Throw now on second and 10. Flushed out right. And he slides to avoid the hit. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
The Jets on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This will be third and 6. Couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
We're into the second half now. This is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And out of bounds, sailed over, looked like right near the pylon. This one's going to be perfect. Directional kicking at its finest, right down at the 1-yard line. The 49ers offense making its way back out there. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself. Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And they give this time to the tailback. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. The Niners on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 7. Over the middle, complete. It's Collins. And they're going to get this one up past the 25. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Back now here on EA Sports. It's 49er football here. They've got the lead as well as we get set to start the fourth and final quarter. Ah! Now they'll run it on the toss. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But the bottom line is he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. 8 yards on the run there, and that leaves him with third and just a couple. And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. Eluding the pressure right. That's complete. It's Collins. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Now a handoff as they run left side. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
Let's go.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
The Niners on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This is third and 7. Time to his left. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Now, they've got to be a little frustrated here to not complete that on third down after having such a long drive going.
Hey, you're talking about going over 70 yards on the drive. Yeah, did you say a little frustrated?
Very frustrated.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. I'm very frustrated. There's no doubt about it. They thought they were going to have a chance to cash in the end zone. Now it looks like it's likely a field goal attempt.
So a big one there is that gives them a little cushion.
And you know, here in the fourth quarter, the fact that they were able to bleed some time off the clock and put points on the board, even if it's only three, that could turn out to be the drive that ultimately wins them the game.
And New York set to take the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. And that one's complete to Gurley. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A gain of 32 that time.
Here we go.
Yet another carry here tonight for Gurley. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Whether it's what we call an even front or an odd front, and an odd front's real easy to figure out. If that guy is lined up over the nose of the center, typically that's an odd front defense. Odd number of people, meaning 3-4 versus the 4-3, which is an even front. You've got to control those guys in the middle. Whether it's the nose or the two defensive tackles in a four-man front, if those guys can't get moved, you cannot run the ball in the middle of the field. And in that play, they were able to actually take care of business.
Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get six on the ground there, and it'll be second and goal coming up. Defensively, they must have been expecting a pass. They were in the dime look out there.
I think maybe they were deciding to go with speed on the field rather than bulk. I'm with you, a little bit surprising. But they wanted people getting to the ball as fast as possible. The lighter shift your defensive backs allow you that opportunity.
They'll try to run it in to Marshall. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the one. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden it's third and goal at the one. They got to have six here. It's third and goal.
Come on, let's go!
And here's Marshall. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Keith Marshall punching it in from a yard away. And the Jets are able to make this a close game again. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating what we have to make the call. They already had it lined up. Never even got to it.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards, as he'll get this only back to the 20. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal. And I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out and out joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the ball.
And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Darren Lee leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six. Time for a break. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. They'll run it now out of the gun. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll use his blockers to get this up over the 20 to the 21. Able to pick up a healthy chunk of yards, 7 yard gain, but a tough 3rd and 9 upcoming. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked up by Jamal Adams. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. You got the slim lead late and the football, so why are you throwing it there?
Remember during the year when we asked one of the head coaches, you know, if you're in this spot, why would you throw the ball? And he talked about trust in his quarterback and trust in his offense.
Still.
And then at the end he kind of went, yeah, not really a good reason.
Now a give running left for Gurley. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Partner, you've got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here. Come on, let's go!
They'll look to throw. Looking middle, and that's complete. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
I'm a little surprised right here. They've got 3 timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
Let's go. And the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. The Jets on third down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This is 3rd and 7. Now Marshall. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. So here now, big spot for the kicker. It's Caleb Sturgis. This to potentially send us to overtime. And Sturgis able to knock it through. And that will tie this game here in the final minute of the play. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the 4th quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, 2nd down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And this may be a carbon copy as he'll again be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10. Overtime in a playoff game. Awesome setup. Remember, the rules the same as they would be in the regular season.
That's exactly right, Brandon. Remember, the receiving team, if they score a touchdown, game is over. But if they kick a field goal or don't score, the other team gets a chance to get the football. They get a possession. If they go down and score, they win the football game at that point. If both teams kick field goals, we keep playing. If a defense scores, let's say the receiving team gets the ball, doesn't score, or they throw a pick six or fumble, gets picked up, the defense scores, game over. But here's the best part. In a regular season, only 1 period is played. We could call it a tie. Here, we're going to play until we have a winner.
They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of 1 yard there, and now 2nd down. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? And almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. And how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
Yeah, they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. 23 yards on the play.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential. But when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run. And he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. They go with the ground game, pick up the first, now in plus territory.
And that changes the whole mentality of a play caller, doesn't it? Once they cross the 50, they feel like they're in the strike zone, all right? You don't have to be in the red zone to take those big shots downfield or go after the end zone. Right now, that might be available to them.
And now this first drive in OT continues. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Casey. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the 4-yard line. That goes for a gain of 31.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays,
That's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
They'll run with Marshall. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Only a yard that time, second and goal. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settling, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. And I know the defensive guys, poking, clawing, raking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field. Well, now they'll try the end around. And a big tackle there as the defender runs right through him. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
Brandon, if I wanted to run the football this close to the goal line, I think I'd just turn around and hand it to my tailback. Too many things could go wrong in this situation. I think they're fortunate just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Another chance to maybe end it right here. This is third and goal. On the handoff, it's Gurley. And he's into the end zone. Move over, James White. You've got a new rival for best finish to a Super Bowl ever. And the New York Jets have won the Super Bowl. And the Lombardi Trophy will be in the Big Apple. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workouts, training camp, week one, two, three, all building up now to say you're a Super Bowl champion. It's worth it.
It certainly is, and rarely do we have a team that hoists the Lombardi Trophy that didn't have their share of bumps along the way, didn't have to face some adversity in the journey. And now they get to just enjoy it and revel in it. And all offseason, they'll be signing their autographs with Super Bowl champion underneath it.
And they end this year just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.